Hello everybody, so we're gonna make some of our ephemera or our pieces that are gonna go into our journal here that we've been working on. So I've had quite a bit of different pieces sitting around and everything, and these are the pages that are left over from my printout, so figured we should use them up. And I made these envelopes with my Cricut Maker a long time ago, and I figured, you know what, that'd work perfectly for inside the journal, so that's what we're gonna do. Finish these pieces up by gluing them and together, and then starting decorate them. And I made these out of scrapbooking paper, so I think this is what we're going to work on first. With the pieces here that we have. Add some of our people to them. There we go. We got one envelope down. Got a few more here to do. And again, I'm just trying to keep it simple, but at the same time, make some pretty cute stuff to put in this journal that we've been making, or not journal, altered book we have been making. So there, we got them three done. And some of these, I think there's going to be too much going on otherwise, so We're just gonna do stuff in threes and get some of these pretty well done. Just because it just needs to get done. I'm sure you guys feel that way sometimes with stuff you make. You just have to finish it. Doesn't matter how, it just needs to get finished. And that's how I feel sometimes when it comes down to works that I'm making. I just want to finish it. I don't want to do too exciting with this book now that I've done so much already to it. So I'm just trying to basic it up a little bit. Which sometimes works and sometimes doesn't. I want to add this to it. And this is only, or small little garment pins here. Not sure what I'm gonna pin into it yet, but I wanted it on there already, ready to go. So basically what I'm doing with this piece of fabric is going to puncture a hole back and forth into it. There we go. So now we got a nice little piece of fabric here hanging off it as decoration. So there's one. Okay. Let's add a bit of lace. That helps brighten it up a little, and then yeah, I like that. All right. And this is a light enough lace. I'm not too worried about using my one thing, and I have lost my pin, of course. There we go. All right. Got that going. Oh, and we want to glue this down next. Now we're gonna stick this on here. And then I'm going to add something in the middle there. Just not sure what yet. Why don't we grab a random piece of stamp to stick there. And if you can't tell, I'm not trying to make every one of them elaborate making. Just some. It all depends on all what's going on in the background and everything else. Butterfly with, I'm gonna add a little bit something here. And this is my vintage lace that I inherited, so I kind of just don't want to use it too much, but at the same time, use it when I'd like to. The lady I got this from was a relative that had died that was a seamstress. So I got a lot of fabric and a lot of different things that I wouldn't normally use. And this is one of them things that I've been kind of hoarding. So I figure might as well use it now. No time like the present. Right. And of course I accidentally bury it. Oh well. I do, on the other hand, want to add make it into a tag. There we go. Just a simple, simplistic way of doing a tag there. All right, 1, 2, 3. Now I really love this side, and I somewhat love this side. I just need something to cover up that. So I'm gonna take one of my pieces of paper that I had from the other bit and glue it down. That's what I'm gonna do. Again, I like that portion, but I don't like seeing this other portion, so. We're gonna take care of that. Add to this part too at the bottom, that's kind of like just a simple way of getting that nice looking again. Oh, and that came apart. So I guess I'm using this to cover the hole. Or reinforce the hole, I should say. There we go. There we go. Nice and stuck to it. And we're gonna glue her down. There we go. Another one bites. Yeah, I'm sorry, that song's in my head today because my lovely youngest daughter, every time I sing Another One Bites the Dust, she has to sing back to me Another One Bites the Dust. And it's been kind of one of them things. We go back and forth and it's fun, but at the same time, I'm sure other people just get annoyed. When I was making my last journal, that's what I'd say. Or start saying. That's what I should say. Okay, that one I kind of want to distress. So it can go with that just makes it a little bit more whoa out of it. There we go, our envelope. And I'm thinking about doing this flat part. You know what? I'm just gonna glue it. Something really nice looking like this. I do just glue it down. Now this will be interesting how I cut this out. Got that portion cut out. Now I'm going to take this portion and cut that out. Now, also thinking, just a cute little closure here. And I try to only glue 3/4 of the piece so the rest of the piece can flip open for this, but be tucked down enough where it ain't gonna affect anything. Then we'll stick some glue right here, stick some glue right there. So I should be able to just take it and push it in there. So we got our envelope there. All right, now next is our next envelope. Oh, sorry. Keep on knocking. Got it. Just thinking. But no, that ain't gonna work. This one, I'm only going to do the front, I think, with it. With this portion of it, I should say. Yeah. Well, no, let's just do the whole thing. If I glue this whole thing on, I should be able to just cut it out like that. Not have any issues. There we go. And I'm probably going to leave this side just plain because this is the type of background that's easy to write on. And I want to add this gal. I might have to cut off her legs, but that's okay. I still think she'd look pretty in it. So, because I'm cutting off the legs, we're going to use the glue here. I was going to use the art glitter glue, but it's wasting the glue then. Where this glue, it makes it just a little. Easier. So. There we go. Done with another envelope. Well, let's do some of these. And these I'm just going to glue. Yet again, just glue in. I'm thinking I'm going to leave the lines though. So, we're going to have the line side showing. You know what? I'm going to take out two cards and we're going to do the same with two cards. We're just going to glue them on. Why not? I have tons of these playing cards. I don't know how or when I all of a sudden got clean playing cards, but I recently found out I have several different ones, so I figure it. We're just gonna use them. So, today I've been watching, what is it? Instead of Grey's Anatomy, I've been watching ER. Now, if there was enough seasons to watch a lot of New Amsterdam, I'd probably be watching a lot of New Amsterdam, but I can't really binge watch New Amsterdam as much. And I tried getting into The Good Doctor. It ain't my thing. I'm normally like medical dramas, but that one I can't seem to like. I like the actor in it, which is weird. I liked him in the Bates Motel and everything. I think it's because the whole autism issue right now to me hits too close to home. I think it'd be different if it didn't hit close to home, but right now, in my mind, it's just hitting too close. Now, I think this side's perfect for writing on, so I'm going to be adding our people to this side. I kind of want these closer to me. Now I'm going to distress. So they're not so white. Stress this out a little bit. And I think I'm going to add words to this one just because. All some pieces you know you have to distress. Some pieces you know you don't really have to worry about it, but with this piece, it seems right to distress it. Seems kind of wrong to leave these cards clean. Itty bitty words. Something very basic here. Our dude, and then the word timeless. I just think that works very well with it. Now, this one, I have an idea. With it, so I'm going to use two words this time. Inspire. Memories. I just totally think that's that girl. Inspire memories. Totally fits. All right. Sorry about that. That was a little bit of a hiccup. These ones I'm just gonna grab and stick. I don't think these need to be distressed at all, actually. So there's one. There's another. So we got our two ladies here. Now we're going to do three bingo cards. Now these, I'm all going to distress all of them. Let's see. How it looks just down the card. cards a little bit here. They just seem so bright and shiny. Dear, I'm hoping that deshines them a little. Just a little bit. Didn't really want to deshine them too much, but just a little. Alright. There's some pieces in here that I know are quite big. Like this lady. And this lady. These two. So I just thought, okay, I'm just going to glue these down on here. I don't want to add too much, but I don't want to add too little either. I do like the idea of doing this behind her a little bit here. Yeah, that works perfectly for her. This lady. All right, and a couple. Yeah, sometimes you just need to add some scrap pieces, I guess, to it. And I'm trying to do this because I know there's going to be a lot of collaging with my next series, just because I'm going to be doing so many golden books. It just makes more sense for me to use up some of my already pre-made ephemera here with this as we work on them books. And that series, I'm hoping I can do one book next week, or start the process, I mean, next week, because I have a feeling it's going to be a lot of processes and a lot of work. I might only do two or three at a time, just because of how many books there are. And I'm hoping during my vacation I can get most of the pieces cut out too. And I completely forgot to distress that. So. I think if I do it the right way, yeah, that should work. there. And again, doing a book like this makes it so I use up some of these pieces that I haven't used and everything, because, yeah. I think what I'm gonna do with this one, set it like that, maybe. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. And based off of when this was made, it was made in 1956. So when it says ladies of the 80s, it's actually talking about 1880s. I just thought that was so amazing, you know, back in 1956, we were calling the 80s the 1880s, and now we're calling the 80s 1980s, and there ain't much difference between then and now, except we're already past the 1980s. So this is the back, and then this will be the front, and I think I'm gonna add a little bit of piece of lace to this. There ain't enough to make another one, so, or use more of this lace, so I am gonna let this hang. I think it's just gonna add a little decorative spice to that. All right, so now we got 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I made a master board with a bunch of artsy stamper stuff, but since I'm no longer a part of her design team, it's just easier for me to gesso over it and go on with my life, I guess. I mean, I love her stuff, don't get me wrong, but I would have never made the master board. I knew I wasn't gonna be there long. I wouldn't have printed out as much either, but it happens, we do that. So there's one. I think that actually looks kind of funny, so I'm going to do this. Here. And I kind of like to leave things a little cleaner than normal with my altered books, because a lot of people want to be able to have their own, like, little... It ain't like a junk journal, a normal junk journal, where you can add and subtract things easier. I mean, you could still do that with an older book, I guess, but I don't know. I just feel like when you order an altered book, you kind of want a little bit of your own freedoms with it. I could be wrong, but I don't know. I feel like that's needed. All right. Now this one. One. I want to choose one of these girls. These two. This one and this one. Ooh, this one goes with the flowers a little bit more. And then I want to add just a bit of gold. Bottom there. And then the other one. Yeah, I definitely like that. There we go. Kind of like she's walking the yellow brick road. I know, I'm having a weird obsession with whatchamacallit, Wizard of Oz, but that's because I made a Wizard of Oz themed junk journal a while ago, and I just, for some reason, I can't get it out of my mind. I mean, we all do that sometimes, don't we? Where we have something on our minds. All right. Now the last one is three of these, but I'm thinking I'm just only going to do two. And it is coffee dyed, or not coffee dyed, food colored dyed is what I should say. And normally I do the front as a the guest check area as the non-writing space, but you know what? Today I feel like doing it opposite for once. Let's make the front the writing space and the back the fun portion. Sorry about that. That probably sounded really loud. Alright, we have four left. I kind of feel like these two. I don't like the panda one for some reason. It's like I have this idea of using any of them except that panda one. And what I am going to do with the rest of this ephemera, because, or not ephemera, but like embellishments and stuff, the pieces that I haven't used, is going to go into a, there, one of my envelopes. It's part of the reason why I made so many envelopes, is so I can just do this. We can just add them in here, and it's just like a little surprise for someone who gets this. There we go. Now,